The Supreme Court has ruled that Shamima Begum, the woman who left Britain as a teenager to join the Islamic State group in Syria, should not be allowed to return here to challenge the removal of her British citizenship. The court ruled unanimously that her rights were not breached when she was refused permission to return. The 21-year-old is currently in a camp in northern Syria. Our Home Affairs correspondent Daniel Sandford reports.
Shamima!
In jeans and a sun hat, Shamima Begum last summer in the Al-Roj camp in northern Syria, where she remains to this day. The Home Secretary has stripped her of her British citizenship for running away to become an Islamic State fighter's bride, aged just 15. At the Supreme Court, her lawyers had argued that she must be allowed to come back to the UK to fight that decision in a fair court hearing. But today, the court unanimously ruled against her, saying her case should simply be postponed. National security comes first.
The right to a fair hearing does not trump all other considerations, such as the safety of the public.
The Supreme Court justices said Parliament had given the Home Secretary the difficult task of making decisions around national security in cases like this. Overturning the Court of Appeal, they said that that court had not given the Home Secretary's assessment the respect it deserved. Shamima Begum and two school friends, both now believed to be dead, left London aged just 15 to join the Islamic State group in Syria. There she married a foreign fighter and had three children, all of whom have now died. When IS's rule collapsed 2 years ago, she reappeared, asking to be allowed home to Britain.
I just want forgiveness, really, from the UK. Like, everything I've been through, I didn't expect I would go through that.
Richard Walton, who is head of Scotland Yard's counter-terrorism command, had tried to stop Shamima Begum and her friends getting to Syria, told me this afternoon the court had made the right decision.
If she'd been allowed to return to the UK by the Supreme Court, she would probably have been arrested by the counter-terrorism command and probably charged with terrorist offences. But the evidence against her would likely have been weak owing to the difficulties of securing evidence in war zones. And when released, she would have presented an ongoing threat and would have needed to be subject to the most rigorous monitoring, costing the country hundreds of thousands of pounds over months and years.
But civil liberties groups say the decision hollows out a cornerstone of British justice and means we may never hear from Shamima Begum her explanation of what happened.
Why was a 15-year-old girl able to go and travel to Syria? Was she trafficked? Was she groomed? Those are questions that we still don't have answers to, and we can't have answers to unless she can participate properly in her appeal and give her side of the story.
There seems no prospect of that for now, and Shamima Begum will remain in Al-Roj camp in legal limbo. A UN special rapporteur has said that Britain was on a list of shame of countries who strip people of their citizenship. Daniel Sandford, BBC News.